गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल।
गुड आफ्टरनून सर।
गुड आफ्टरनून, दिस इज फ्लैगशिप बैच राइट?
यस सर।
इफ आई एम राइट, वी डेल्ट विथ एंगुलर मोमेंटम। वी आर सपोज टू डील विथ कोलिजन्स इन एंगुलर मोमेंटम।
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Listen. Suppose there is a thin rod hanging vertically such that it is hinged at the topmost point. And there is small m moving with a velocity of capital M and L. Now, small m collides with capital M. There are two types of collisions here. Could be elastic, could be inelastic. It may stick to the rod, may not stick to the rod. It can be even elastic collision. First point here, I cannot conserve linear momentum because of the normal force at the hinge. Linear momentum is not conserved. Why? Due to normal force at hinge. Linear momentum is not conserved due to normal force at hinge. Here I will have a normal force. That's an external force. That too an impulsive force. Impulsive. Yaad rakho the word. What can I conserve here? L only about hinge is conserved. L only about the hinge is conserved. Why? Torque about the hinge is zero. Since torque about O is zero, I am calling this point O. What is the initial angular momentum and what is the final angular momentum? Just of the collision, let me take this to be omega. Let me take this mass to be moving with a velocity v, just of the collision. Right? So, first of all, initial angular momentum about O for the rod is zero. For small m, extend the line of action of linear momentum and drop it perpendicular. M u into L, anti-clockwise. Initial angular momentum about O. Is this step clear to all?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Final angular momentum about O will be M v into L. mv into L plus angular momentum of the rod about O, I about O into omega. I about O will be capital ML square by 3. Moment of inertia about one extreme end. Moment of inertia about one extreme end. Capital ML square by 3. Minus MUL, minus MPL, minus ML square by 3 into omega. I have two variables V and omega. I have two variables V and omega. I need one more equation. They will tell you what kind of a collision it is. Elastic collision, perfectly inelastic collision. So small e will be relative velocity of separation upon approach at the point of contact along the common line. Relative velocity of separation upon relative velocity of approach at the point of contact along the common one. This is L omega, relative velocity of separation upon relative velocity of approach at the point of contact along the common normal. This will be L omega minus V upon U minus 0. L omega minus V upon initial velocity of small m minus initial velocity. Two equations and two variables. They will give you what kind of collision it is. They tell you perfectly elastic, put E equal to 1. Perfectly inelastic, put E equal to 0. Semi-inelastic, give me the value of E, I will substitute here. Two equations and two variables.
So this E equation was at the moment when it just collided.
Just before collision and just after collision.
Okay, sir.
Even angular momentum ka just before and just after.
Sir, by writing the moment of inertia as ml square by 3, didn't we already consider that it is it's not a perfectly inelastic collision?
Why?
Sir, because if the mass would stick, then we would have also written ml square, right?
If the mass sticks, put E equal to 0.
Sir, so but then
our omega substitute here, you are getting the
sir, but oh, sir, but won't our equations change then?
Substitute and see. Hawa mein teer kyun maar rahe ho? Mere liye homework kyun? Ab substitute karke dekho. If you are taking whole of this as one system, what will you write here? Put E equal to 0, verify if you are getting the same equation or not.
Okay, sir.
Sir, could you repeat the part why angular momentum is conserved about hinge? Kyunki mg ka nahi lagega kya?
Normal force. L is conserved only about the hinge because normal force passes through the hinge and torque because of the normal force is zero.
Sir, I didn't understand.
Torque only about the hinge is zero. Find out the point about which torque is zero for this. You find out independently. Tell me the point about which torque for small m, capital M put together is zero. Bolo.
Nahi hai sir, aur koi.
Only hinge par torque zero ho raha hai. Yes, sir.
Why, sir?
Sir, mg ka nahi effect hoga kya?
Ye vertical rod hai.
Nahi sir, like collide hone ke baad.
Just after collision, you are yet in this position only.
Okay, sir.
कोई normal force के बारे में बोल रहा है, you will have to refer to the third, fourth lecture of rotation where normal force due to hinges I covered in detail. You will know what at through which point normal forces are passing.
Yes, sir.
Yes, you forgot that.
No, sir, I didn't. But okay.
Normal force about the hinge is passing through which point?
The through normal force about the hinge. It's passing through the body.
Through the hinge?
Yes, sir.
Ha ha. Yes, sir.
Yeah, ha ha.
Yes, sir.
So torque about the hinge is zero.
Ha, okay. So momentum is not conserved. Normal momentum kyun nahi conserved? Linear momentum.
नॉर्मल फोर्स है ना
डर क्या रहा है
अच्छा ओके
नॉर्मल फोर्स के बारे में बोल रहा है इंपल्सिव फोर्स है बोला हुआ है व्हाट्स रॉन्ग विथ यू क्लियरली लिखा हुआ है ड्यू टू नॉर्मल फोर्स चेंज अभी अभी नॉर्मल फोर्स के बारे में बात किया यू विल हैव एन एक्स एंड एन वाई We dealt with all this already. I cannot go back to such an extent. Try to understand.
Yes.
Noted, sir.
No, sir, wait. Done, sir. Done.
What if a rod is not hinged? You people play pen fight. School mein karte the?
Bahut pehle.
One pen, another pen, you make it strike. Jiska pen table se gir gaya, he lost the game, the other is the winner. Sahi bola maine?
Yes, sir.
Here we are taking a thin rod and a point. Thin rod. And a point mass moving with a velocity of u on a horizontal smooth tip. On a horizontal smooth table, just after collision, this will be moving with VCM. This will be omega, and the mass will be moving with a velocity v. Let L be the length of the rod. So far, so good. Yes, or no?
Yes, sir. Sir.
Sir, but how do we know that it will rotate about its center of mass only?
Omega for a rigid body, about any point omega will be the same.
Oh, yeah, yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now, in this case, nothing is hinged. I can conserve linear momentum. Mu plus 0 is mv plus capital M into v. Conservation of linear momentum. Is it valid?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Conservation of angular momentum can be done about any point because nothing is hinged. It's on a smooth horizontal tape. So generally, textbooks write conserve angular momentum about this point. Do you recollect when we started this concept, we said we would always prefer a point which is at rest
and yes, not sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So you will select a point in A which is at rest. When the rod moves ahead, the point remains there. When the rod moves ahead, the point remains there. I have selected this point in A, which is at rest. So when the rod moves ahead, the point will remain there. This point, is it clear?
Sir, can you once again explain?
There is a point at the center of the rod, but the point is in A, or space. When the rod moves ahead, the point will remain there. The point is at rest. You have selected a point which is at rest. When the rod
goes ahead, yes,
the point remains there.
Yes, yes.
Why
sir.
Did you select a point at rest? Will be understood during the course of this lecture. So, I am conserving angular momentum about this. What is the initial angular momentum? Mu into L by 2 plus angular zero. Momentum of the rod 0. Angular momentum of small m with respect to this point. Mv into L by 2 plus angular momentum of the rod about this point. How did you tell me to calculate angular momentum? Angular momentum of the rod about its center of mass plus angular momentum of center of mass with respect to this point. Angular momentum of the rod about its center of mass plus angular momentum of center of mass with respect to this point. Angular momentum of the rod about its center of mass is ICM omega. Everything is clockwise, so I'm going positive. Plus, angular momentum of center of mass with respect to this point, extend the line of action of angular momentum and drop a perpendicular.
Zero.
Yes.
M VCM zero. I repeat both the equations. Listen to me carefully. Conservation of linear momentum will not be difficult for you. Mu plus zero is MV plus capital MVCM. Angular momentum, which point did you select? This point, center of the rod in air, which is at rest, which is at rest. Rod moves ahead, the point remains there.
Sir, the point is on the table, right?
Angular momentum of this mu about this is mu into L by 2. This is clockwise. Angular momentum of the rod about this is zero. Final angular momentum of small m about this point, mv into L by 2. Angular momentum of the rod about this point is angular momentum of the rod about its center of mass plus angular momentum of center of mass with respect to this point. Angular momentum of the rod about its center of mass is ICM omega. This angular momentum of center of mass with respect to this point, MVCM into R perpendicular. R perpendicular is Z. Now, I have three variables. V is one variable, VCM is one variable, omega is one variable. Small e, relative velocity of separation upon relative velocity of approach along the common normal at the point of contact. Relative velocity of separation upon relative velocity of approach along the common normal at the point of contact. Right? What will the velocity of this point be? With respect to center of mass, it will be L by 2 omega.
Plus VCM.
Plus VCM is the velocity of this point.
Yes.
No, relative velocity of separation. L by 2 omega plus VCM minus V upon initial velocity of this
point. Minus zero.
Minus Z. This velocity minus this velocity upon initial velocity of this minus initial velocity of this along the common normal at the point of contact. Along the common normal at the point of contact.
Yes, sir.
Take it down till here. We will learn conservation of angular momentum about another point as well.
Sir, will that point be the point of contact?
Yes. But again, in air, which is at rest.
Yes, sir.
But this was possible because the torque about any point in this case would be zero, right?
Perfect.
Okay, sir.
Done, sir.
So wait, please.
So wait, please.
Sir.
So
can you explain the second equation?
Teen bar explain kiya yaar. I should know what is your doubt so that I can address it. Aisa main same thing repeat karte jaunga to fayda nahi. tell me your doubt in that second equation and let us.
So my doubt is how MVCM is multiplied by zero. I forgot the formula.
Extend the line of action of this and drop a perpendicular on it from
here. Ah, okay, got it, sir. Thank you.
Here you will write a statement, angular momentum conserved, likho, for this, note, for this, angular momentum is conserved about the center of the rod which is a point in A, and at rest, which is a point in A and at rest. At rest, underline karo. Now, let us conserve angular momentum about another point, which will be generally the most preferred point. Why? With many zeros in it, your simplification will become much easier. Have a look. The point selected is this. This is the point P. The point selected is the point of contact, but in air, which is at rest. Do you see that when the rod moves ahead, the point remains here?
Yes.
Now, what is the initial angular momentum of small m with respect to the point P?
Zero,
because mu is passing through that point.
Yes, sir.
What is the initial angular momentum of the rod about the point P?
Zero.
Again, zero.
Final angular momentum of small m about point P is again zero.
No.
In an equation, when you see so many zeros, simplification becomes very easy. Now, don't tell me all are zeros. No, sir. Zero equal to zero, you will be proving and not. Now, angular momentum of the rod about this point P is angular momentum of the rod about its center of mass plus angular momentum of center of mass with respect to the point P. Angular momentum of the rod about its center of mass plus angular momentum of center of mass with respect to the point P. So firstly, angular momentum of the rod about its center of mass, ICM omega, clockwise. Angular momentum of center of mass with respect to the point P is clockwise or anticlockwise?
Sorry, anticlockwise.
Minus capital M VCM into L by 2. Angular momentum of the rod about its center of mass plus angular momentum of center of mass with respect to this particular point. Is capital M VCM into L by 2 anticlockwise? Simplification will become much easier.
Yes, sir.
Because of 330s. So those standard textbooks say conserve angular momentum about center of the rod, about a point which is at rest. We would prefer the point of contact. Small e will be L by 2 omega plus VCM minus V upon U minus 0. Can you take a problem and show us by both the procedures? We will take it down till you. Can I read the board?
Yes.
Now listen to this. This is the 61st problem of HCV. Something he wants to teach you people in this particular question. 61st problem of HCV. Moving with a velocity of u. It sticks to the rod just after collision. I'll call this VCM, I'll call this omega, and it sticks to the rod. Suppose the particle has a mass and speed V sticks to the rod after collision. The rod has a mass of capital M and length is L. Now he makes you conserve the angular momentum about a moving point. The two points that we selected were
at rest.
Why? Recollect, when you conserve, when you calculated angular momentum about rho, if this is V, this is U, ICM omega plus M V minus U, this calculation will be bad. Extend that and drop a perpendicular. R perpendicular. So if you are selecting a moving point, you will have to find out the angular momentum with respect to the moving point. Do you agree with that?
Yes, sir.
That's a headache. But he makes you go through this problem meticulously using 7 bits. Step by step, he makes you calculate that. Why? Didn't he know that it would be much easier to conserve angular momentum about either the center of the rod or a point of contact? He must have. Then why is he making the student do this? Because he wants the student to realize one important concept. What is that concept? We will come to at the end of the problem. Right now, first equation for us. He asked for velocity of center of mass. VCM was asked. What is the velocity of center of mass? Mu plus 0 upon small m plus capital. This is mu upon small m plus capital M. Then he is asking you to calculate velocity of small m with respect to center of mass. If you want me to conserve angular momentum about the center of mass, then I'll have to ask you to calculate velocity of small m with respect to center of mass. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I'll call this V naught. This will be velocity of center of mass. Right? This is small m. This will be L by 2 omega plus V. Just after collision is in red color, before collision is in blue color. Now, velocity of small m with respect to center of mass. Initial velocity of small m with respect to center of mass is u minus velocity of center of mass is mu upon small m plus capital M. This is capital mu upon small m plus capital M. Am I right? Yeah. Velocity of capital M with respect to center of mass. 0 minus mu upon small m plus capital M is minus mu upon small m plus capital M. You are procuring information. Velocity of small m with respect to center of mass, velocity of capital M with respect to center of mass, and then you are calculating what? I'll calculate this distance x. You have to calculate because velocity, linear momentum of small m with respect to center of mass into the perpendicular distance. What is the perpendicular distance? X. So we are procuring information initially. How much would be the value of x? I take this at the origin. In the downward direction, what are the coordinates of small m?
M comma 0.
Capital M L by 2 upon small m plus capital. Small m's coordinate in this direction is 0. Capital M's coordinate is L by 2. This will be capital ML 2 times small m plus capital. Then what will this distance be? L by 2 minus x. L by 2 minus x. L by 2 minus x is L by 2 minus capital ML 2 times small m plus capital. L by 2 minus x. L by 2 minus x. Have a look at L by 2 taken common. Small m plus capital M. Small m plus capital M minus capital M. This is ML by 2 times small m plus capital M. You have been procuring information till now to do what? To conserve angular momentum about a moving point. Then kitna lamba ho raha hai dekho. To even conserve angular momentum about the moving point, you will have to find out the velocities with respect to the moving point.
Yes, sir.
So now you found out velocity with respect to the moving point of both small m and capital M. You calculated perpendicular distances. Now I have the information to conserve angular momentum about the moving point, which I will I need the board. We are half done with the problem. Take it down till here. And you'll have to make a note of these values properly. I'll not remember them. When I'm applying conservation of angular momentum, I'll ask you for those values. You'll have to help me out.
So could you repeat how you got x?
X, center of mass for me. I took this as origin. So small n's coordinate into zero. Capital N's coordinate from this origin is L by 2. M1 x1 plus m2 x2 upon m1 plus m2.
Okay, sir. Got it.
Sir, at the end, what were we supposed to find?
We'll realize that later. While I take
up. Currently, I'm not.
Okay. Wait.
1 minute.
Sir, I got disconnected for like the entire time. Recording is available today, no?
Yeah. I'll be uploading it on the YouTube.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Done, sir. 1 minute, sir.
For these two values and these two values, kindly tell me the value. I'll rub the board and I'll proceed. I'll not have that. Firstly, L initial, I will calculate about the moving center. Rather, he asked you to calculate about it. This is the fourth way. Find the angular momentum of the system about the center of mass. Center of mass is a moving point?
Yes, sir.
Angular momentum of small n with respect to center of mass is UMC into X. Do you agree with that?
Yes, sir.
Linear momentum extend and drop a perpendicular X plus angular momentum of the rod with respect to center of mass, capital M. Rod is moving in the backward direction with respect to center of mass. You had a negative sign there. So it's moving backwards. Velocity of capital M with respect to center of mass into the perpendicular distance is L by 2 minus x. Angular momentum of small m with respect to center of mass, angular momentum of capital M with respect to center of mass. Firstly, is this expression clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Why didn't I carry negative sign here? U is in the backward direction with respect to center of mass, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. It is already there now in U of M with respect to center of mass.
So when I'm substituting the value, you want me to put the negative sign?
We have already taken the radius vector.
No, sir.
No, no, because both are clockwise angular momentum. Have a look about the center of mass. This is clockwise. This is also clockwise. The negative sign in the velocity tells me it is clockwise angular momentum. About the center of mass, this is clockwise. Do you agree with that?
Yes.
Yes.
So I will add both of them. Both are clockwise angular momentums. Now, tell me the initial value of this.
M capital MU, capital MU upon small m plus capital M.
Value of x.
Capital M L by 2 into m plus m.
Minus. Small mu by m plus m.
Minus I will not carry because both are clockwise angular momentum. L by 2 minus x the value.
Small ml by sm.
So far,
at
so
2.
Small m capital M UL upon 2 times small m plus capital M is the change. L final about center of mass. L final is IC into omega. Only yeah. IC into omega. Yes. It is about the center of mass, angular momentum of the body about its center of mass plus angular momentum of center of mass with respect to itself. The angular momentum of the body about its center. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
Sir, can you repeat it again?
Angular momentum of the body about its center of mass plus angular momentum of center of mass about itself.
Okay, sir. Yes, sir.
Now, IC will be, as far as the rod is concerned, first I will calculate moment of inertia about this and I translate it about this. I know about the center of the rod. Capital ML square by 12 plus capital M into L by 2 minus X whole square. This is moment of inertia of the rod about center of mass. Parallel axis theorem. Plus, small m into this distance is x square, that into omega. Capital ML square by 12 plus capital M, L by 2 minus x value is this, right? Small m square, L square, 4 times small m plus capital M whole square. L by 2 minus x value I substitute here. Small m L 2 times small m plus capital. Small m into x square. Where is x? This is x. Capital M square L square by 4 times small m plus capital M whole square. whole of this into omega. Omega is not visible on the board. You obviously know you have to carry that omega there. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, I am running short of space. Two steps you have to do. Iska LCM le sakte ho?
Haan, sir.
Yes,
sir. This is L final, this is L initial. Can you equate and find out omega?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
I am waiting for you people. You will tell me the value of omega, which I will write. That is what HCV made you do. Itna lamba gaya hai. Kyun gaya? Because you selected a moving point. So fir HCV, has he gone mad? Why did he make us solve using such a long procedure?
Anything that has gone.
Pardon?
Nothing, sir.
So we will analyze why he made us do this once you give me the board. But first, take LCM for this. Equate L final to L initial. Tell me the value of omega. Then alone we will go ahead.
Sir, can you please once explain the equation of moment of inertia?
Moment of inertia of the rod.
Yes,
ml square by 12 plus m into this distance whole square.
Yes, sir.
Small m x square.
Oh, okay.
I about C.
Sir.
Huh?
Sir, like we say for almost all the bodies, like angular momentum about a point will be the angular momentum about its center of mass plus angular momentum of the center of mass with respect to ground. Can't we say this thing
point.
With respect to that point. So can't we say the same thing for the entire system?
Yes. Entire system ka center mass hi kya na yaar, pura system ka center mass
count. Yes, sir. So as we solved the previous question, why can't we simply add the angular momentum of the center of mass with respect to the point
you
in
can,
the
I have no problem with that. You can, it is the same labor, also will be the same. I took whole of the system IC. You want to take angular momentum of small m separate while doing about the center of the rod, agar chahiye to us procedure mein kar dunga. I have no problem with it.
Oh.
Aapke liye ye solve karke tell me the value of omega. I am waiting. you people should get the answer 6 mu upon 4 small m plus capital M into L. Please do the simplification properly. All you have to do is first add these two, then add this, it becomes much simpler. LCM lay low and then equate it to this. You get the value of omega. I am waiting for you people. People who are unable to take the LCM, stand upside down, take a video of it and post it to me.
YouTube.
Done, sir.
All of you got the answer, Omega?
Yes, sir.
Now, this is what HCV made you do. Well, what are you claiming? You are claiming select a point at rest, your life will become much simpler. This is what you are telling me?
Yes.
Right from the start?
Yes.
So before I proceed, show us that you select a point at rest, your life will become much simpler. I'll show you, have a look at it. I will select a point which is here, so that I can do the comparison easily. This point is what I selected. The combined center of mass would come here. That point is at rest when the system moves ahead. Did you understand which point I have taken? Advantage. Have a look. L initial. I have selected a point which is at rest. So it will be mu into x. Now velocity with respect to this point is u. Right? Mu. What is the value of x? Capital ML upon small m plus capital M. Yes or no? Two times. If I know the value of x, I get L initial in two steps. What did you do the comparison here? You selected this point, which should be the future point. The point at rest, L initial. Don't you think the simplification is easier than the one I have done previously?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
First point, we are convinced that if we select a point at rest, life becomes much simpler. Right? L final will be the same. Why? Because angular momentum of the body about its center of mass plus angular momentum of center of mass with respect to this point. Right? IC into omega. Now this and this you equate, you will get the same answer. So firstly, I made my mark here by telling you that selecting a point at rest makes your life simple. The other two points I discussed, take this down. And write clearly what this point is. What will you call this point as? Tell me a symbol. C dash?
M dash.
C dash. Right here. L about C dash. Name this point as C dash. Later on, you should know. C dash is a point which is at rest. Now back to square one. When you introduced this concept today, what did you tell me will be the simplest way of doing the problem? Conserving angular momentum about?
Point at rest.
Point of contact at rest. Conserving angular momentum about point of contact at rest in A. Do you agree with this?
Yes.
Yes.
Solve and show me that it will be much simpler than what HCB made us do. First, write conservation of linear momentum. Mu plus 0 is small m into L by 2 omega plus V naught plus capital M into V naught. First equation is conservation of linear momentum. Anybody with a doubt in this? Second equation is conservation of angular momentum about point P. About point P is mu into 0 plus angular momentum of the rod about this is 0. Angular momentum of small m about this point is 0. Till here, all of you convinced?
Yes, sir.
Now, angular momentum of the rod about point P will be angular momentum of the rod about its center of mass, ICM omega, minus capital M V naught into L by ICM omega. And why is this minus? Anticlockwise, M V naught into L by 2 is anticlockwise, ICM omega is clockwise. This is what you told me is much simpler to simplify. Let us cross verify that we get the same answer. If I can eliminate V naught from here, my job is done. How do I write this? 0 plus 0 is equal to 0 plus these two. Capital ML square by 12 into omega is capital M V naught into L by capital M L 6. V naught is omega L by 6. Substitute this V naught here and here. Mu is equal to M omega L by 2 plus M V naught omega L by 6 plus capital M omega L by 6. Have a look. M omega L by 2. M V naught. V naught is omega L by 6. Capital M V naught omega L by 6. 6. 3M plus M. 4M plus capital M omega L is mu. Omega is 6 mu upon 4 small m plus capital M into L. Don't you think this is much, much, much simpler than what HCV made you do? Then why did HCV make you solve about this particular point? Will be explained. Take it down. Tell me when I can rub the board.
So you can erase the board.
Now, before we proceed, you started today's concept by conserving angular momentum about the center of the rod in air, which is at rest. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Shows even that will give us the same answer. We'll be happy. It will be a consolidated way of looking at it. Selecting this point, center of the rod, in air, which is at rest, when the rod moves ahead, the point will remain there. Conservation of linear momentum is the same. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Conservation of angular momentum about this point. Mu into L by 2. Mu into L by 2. Angular momentum of the rod about this point is zero. Now, angular momentum of small m with respect to this point is small m into L by 2 omega plus V naught into the perpendicular distance is L by 2. Small m into this velocity into this perpendicular distance is angular momentum of small m with respect to this point plus angular momentum of the rod about this point is angular momentum of the rod about its center of mass plus angular momentum of center of mass with respect to this point. Angular momentum of the rod about its center of mass is angular momentum. Does angular momentum of center of mass with respect to this will be zero? Capital ML square by 1. Somebody asked in the start, can I conserve angular momentum separately for small m and capital M? I have done. Angular momentum of small m into its velocity into L by angular momentum of the rod about its center of mass plus angular momentum of center of mass of the rod with respect to this point will be zero. Second equation. How many variables do you have? V naught and omega. Two equations and two variables. If I eliminate V naught, should I get omega?
Yes, sir.
6 mu upon 4 small m plus capital M into L. Is it the answer that you are expecting?
Yes, sir.
You will get. You can bank on. If not, do the simplification. Which will you prefer among the two?
We trust you.
Great, I know. That was the expected answer. Take this down and write clearly that you have conserved angular momentum about the center of the rod, slightly above in A. Center of the rod, slightly above in A. About O. L about O. Right? Actually, you will get the answer. Take it down till here. We will deal with why HCV made us solve using such a long decision.
So you keep saying it like it's some suspense.
It is. I'll break the ice after this. He did something really great with the talk.
Sir, will there be any circumstances where we will be forced to do everything on the center of, the velocity, the center of mass?
No. Tell me when I can rub the board.
Done, sir.
Now listen carefully. Somewhere in the year 2003, if I remember, one student asked me, other than HCV's procedure, every point I selected was at rest. What are all the points that you solved about? You solved about this point.
Okay.
Then you solved about the point P. Then you solved about O. All three points that you selected points at rest. Kindly select one point which is moving and solve it for us. genuine doubt from the student side?
Yeah.
I said, okay, select this point only, center of the rod, which is moving. Select which point? Center of the rod, which is moving, not in A. Not in A. Let us see what happens. First equation will remain the same. Conservation of linear momentum. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Second equation, may first expression, will it change? Center of the rod, O. Mu into L by 2. Mm. This will be the same?
No. No, it will be the same.
Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Now come to this expression. Angular momentum of the small m with respect to the center of the rod. Center of rod is moving now. So what will velocity of this with respect to this be? Only L by 2 omega?
Yes,
if I select the center of the rod which is moving, what is the velocity of small m with respect to center of the rod? Only L by 2 omega. V naught will be removed. Say something if you are convinced from it.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Last expression will be the same. Center of the rod, ICM omega.
Yeah.
Now, using common sense, I understand one thing. This equation and this equation, if it gave me the answer, by just removing V naught, I will not get the answer. I should make one more change in the equation. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Actually, we didn't get the answer. I solved about the center of the rod which is moving. I did not get the answer. We resolved it in the class. Again, I got the wrong answer. Then for a minute, we stopped and we thought, where are we going wrong? We used common sense then. This equation is the same. This equation, everything is the same. When I take the point at rest for which I am getting the answer, by only removing V naught, I will not get the answer. And I was not getting the answer. Listen very carefully. I cannot conserve angular momentum about the center of the rod. Why? Center of the rod was just before collision. At rest, just after collision, it is moving with a velocity v. Don't you think center of the rod accelerated in that short time interval dt?
Yeah.
If center of the rod accelerated, then I should put a pseudo force. Kahan par daloge? Combined center of mass per pseudo force dalna padega?
Yes,
एक बार कंबाइंड सेंटर ऑफ मास पर स्यूडो फोर्स डालते ही टॉर्क अबाउट द सेंटर ऑफ द रॉड इज नॉट जीरो. टॉर्क इज नॉट जीरो. कंजर्वेशन ऑफ एंगुलर मोमेंटम विल बी रॉन्ग. हेंस यू विल नॉट गेट द आंसर इफ यू टेक ए मूविंग पॉइंट ऑन द सेंटर ऑफ द रॉड बिकॉज the center of the rod accelerated. It was at rest. Suddenly started moving. It accelerated. It CV ka point bhi move kar raha hai na yaar. It CV jo point select kiya hua hai. It is not accelerating. It is combined center of mass of the system which will move with uniform velocity. First bit was velocity of center of mass. Last bit is again velocity of center of mass. After collision also, combined center of mass will be moving with the same speed. Combined center of mass of small m and capital M is uniform velocity. Above all, even if it accelerates, pseudo force will be put on the combined center of mass.
Yeah,
torque due to pseudo force will be zero. Torque due to pseudo force will be zero. So this is the only moving point about which conveniently you can conserve angular momentum. Any other point on the rod, you will not be permitted to conserve angular momentum because that point which was at rest immediately started moving after collision. immediately started moving implies it accelerated in that short time interval. There will be a pseudo force on the center of mass in the opposite direction. Torque due to the pseudo force about this point is non-zero. Torque is non-zero. Angular momentum cannot be conserved. So you have two important things. Either select a point which is at rest, non-accelerating, or take the combined center of mass of the system so that the torque about that will become zero. So the only moving point about which you can conserve angular momentum is the point which HCV made you do. Is this concept clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now you understood why he made you solve in such a long process?
Yes, sir.
एक प्रॉब्लम डिस्कस किया हम लोगों ने इट अपीयर्स फनी दैट फॉर होल ऑफ द क्लास यू डिस्कस वन क्वेश्चन बट नाउ यू सी हाउ इंपॉर्टेंट इट इज यू नो एवरी डैम पॉइंट अबाउट विच यू कैन कंजर्व एंगुलर मोमेंटम एनी डैम पॉइंट एट रेस्ट कंजर्व मूविंग पॉइंट इट शुड बी अलोंग द लाइन ऑफ द सेंटर ऑफ मास ओनली देन यू कैन कंजर्व एंगुलर मेक ए नोट ऑफ इट
So, if the moving point on the rod was, let's say, ekdam niche, okay.
Pseudo force aa jayega, that point accelerate. The rod will move, maybe backward, maybe forward.
Yeah.
Will move. The pseudo force combined center of mass are done. Torque will not be zero.
Yes. Okay, sir.
Sir, I got the same value of omega even though you cancelled the second equation. How is that possible?
Matlab, after removing V naught, you are getting
the same answer? Yeah, no, I just compare the two equations. So, from there you can say that V naught is equal.
After removing V naught, this and this equation you solve and are you getting the same omega?
So I didn't remove, I just compared the two equations and from there I said that V naught is equal to L omega by 6.
Are you with V naught, you will get the answer is what I'm telling.
Oh, it's out of the bracket. Oh, sorry, I didn't see.
With V naught, right, you will get the answer. That is 0.0.
Oh, yes, sir.
If I select the point on the center of the rod which is moving, then I will not get the answer.
Yes, sir.
Go through whole of the lecture. To my knowledge, you did not understand the main essence in the last. The way you are asking me, V naught,
okay,
you have messed it up. Go through whole of this lecture once.
Okay, sir.
We will solve problems on this subtopic in the next class. When is our next lecture?
Wednesday.
So see you people in Wednesday's class. Good day. Bye.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.